my friends, we check out the Gold World Chapter data mining on the ESO Model Viewer website. As always, I will post the link to the ESO Model Viewer website in the comments and in the description, so you can check out also the website and the data mining yourself. And thank you so much for ESO Model Viewer for preparing also the data. I really appreciate that, because I love to see the data mining. If you are not aware what the data mining is, it's not like all these items will be released on an ESO. Maybe they will. We don't know when, maybe soon, maybe never. So if you now see here something what you really want to have, maybe it will be in the game, maybe not. So don't be mad if there's something not coming soon-ish. It's just data mining. So, also we have Adornment, Miss Carkent. I have no clue what that means. There's some monocle, okay? So, monocle. I think it's tough to see something with this monocle. It looks fancy. It looks like this stained glass windows. And I'm not sure if it's really handy to watch. but if you want to look good, that's yours. Then we have a dormant Molag Ball Masquerade Viewer. If you always wanted to be on Halloween, or in Germany on Carnival or Fasching as Molag Ball, now you have the chance and you can get this helm. Why not? But it's an adornment. It's not a helm. So it's called adornment. Interesting. I don't need it, but maybe you need it. Then we have another adornment, the Queen Irene's Admiri Circlet. I couldn't imagine people will like this a lot. Also probably not for me, but I can imagine it will be a popular item. Next up we have Red Diamond Earrings. Red Diamonds, do. Also probably popular. I know, Logan, that Halloween and Fasching and Carnival are not the same, but that's three things I know what people maybe can refer to. So. Assistant. Oh! A new banker, guys. Assistant Eri, Barking Banker. Okay, I don't need it because we have an Alifik. We have a little cat. But if you want to have a dog, a really good boy. Here you go. He looks cute. See, you have some bags on the side. And a little lantern, I think, even. He looks super cute. That's a cute idea. But there's no only a banker. But I assume there will be later also probably a merchant and stuff like that. So I can imagine, yeah. But really cute, but expensive. So... that's always too bad with these bankers and everything. The assistants, they're really, really expensive. So, body markings. Body art of the five companions. Yeah. Tattoos. Then we have more tattoos. Rose of Tamriel body marks. As you know, I'm not a huge fan of the body markings usually. Maybe it's something for you. Body markings, soul burst, body soul markings. This one I could even maybe imagine because it's blue. But otherwise, usually don't need it. Class Arcanist. Ah, so, probably because when a new chapter is released, then the old chapter, you know, you can then purchase the Arcanist or whatever was part of the chapter, then extra. I think that's the reason why we can see that now. Then costume King Eric's Diamond Regalia. Ooh. Could be fancy. But depends how it's dying. I have to see that in game, but it really depends how what you can dye on this costume and how well it does dye. It's always a bit tough sometimes with the colors. I could imagine that here the crown, this one, and the belt maybe does not dye well or not at all. And also here on the boots. I mean, often the special reliefs and stones or diamonds what they have, often don't die at all. But I don't know. Just guessing. We have to check that out in-game. It's pretty cool. Costume Prince Prince Irnsgar's Gala Regalia. Pretty nice. This would be popular. For sure. It's pretty cool. Oh. It's really nice. As people will love it just for the helm. I'm pretty sure about that. Then we have Costume Queen Irene's Diamond Gown. Ooh. Okay. I don't need this dress, but I know people will like this dress a lot. A lot. So I can imagine people are looking forward to this one. And like the costume. Looks like, you know, really intricate and everything. So really nice. Then we have Crafting Motive Blind Path Cultist. Ach, this video I released on Monday. If you want to see the showcase, go on my YouTube channel. So take a look. So, Crafting Motive Shardborn. Oh, this one I don't have yet. Shardborn. I have to see if it's on a PTS. Shardborn. And then we have the recollection style. Yeah, I saw that video showcase I did release while I was vacation. And people pointed out that I made a mistake. The lady is correct, but on the showcase on a male character, for the heavy part, instead of using this one here, I showed the heavy part from the Blind Path Cultist. I don't know how that happened, and I don't know how I did not see that, because they were clearly different. But I guess it happened because I was so much in stress and preparing so many videos in advance for the vacation and everything. It just slipped. So I'm sorry about that. If you watched that, I'm sorry. But yeah, I think it's pretty obvious which is the right one. So then we have Diamond Anniversary Crown Crate. This is one crown crate. Here are four. And a mountain. 15. And then 25. And the 25 bundle is loading. Oh, I guess this is it's for teleporting, or is it do you think it's a mini dolmen? As like the chains from the dolmen, like they're coming down, but in mini? That's pretty cool. That would be really unique. So depends now how it looks like. I mean, it's just an action. You know, it's just a different form how the teleporting looks like. But that is pretty unique compared to the other stuff what we had, which were mostly recoloring, etc. I mean, that's quite unique. Depends how it looks in-game. Also, as always, I would like to see the animation, everything. If it's worth to get it for that. I mean, 25 crates are quite a lot. And as always, in case someone is not aware about crown crates in ESO, you don't know what you get. So in this case, you know, when you buy 25, you get this action, but that's it. So, but that's pretty unique. So, then we have Crown Crate Dark Brotherhood. It's for update 43, so that's in the future. And Crown Crate Mirror More, update 44, much more in the future. Then Crown Crate Carnival for update 45. And customized action Bone Harvest. Oh, but it's like for flowers collecting. Then you have the for necromancer. That would be pretty cool, huh? Yeah, see, customized action Cold Harbor Recall. That's really like that, like a mini dolmen. That's pretty unique indeed. So then we have customized action Gold Road Recall. That's pretty. Also, I could imagine that could be look really nice. As it depends now if there are more effects in-game, but with the leaves and everything, I could imagine that this is really beautiful. Or, also, at least I can imagine that. Looking forward to see that in-game. That sounds really nice. Even so, as I said, So far, I did not buy any customized actions because I think they're a bit overpriced for that what they do. If they would be cheaper, I would probably own already many. But so far, I only got one crown crates. Yeah, that's it. But this one looks nice. Emote Apple Intimidation. Oh, poor Apple. he's angry with the Apple, I guess. Then we have Emote Celebratory Dance. Okay, they are celebrating and dancing. That's a difficult word, I'm sorry. Okay, what about dancing emote? Then we have Emote I Shall Remember This. Oh, they did steal and or prank them and steal apples and they are angry and do remember that. Then Emote Skin Guard Noble Snack. That's the one which you got from watching the ESO stream, I believe. This one with the grapes. Furniture Cold Harbor Sentinel. Ooh. I could imagine this people like a lot. Or for housing enthusiasts, I could imagine that they will like that a lot. Would be really nice. I hope it will not be too expensive. Then we have Furniture Dietrich Statue Sanguine. Just animated, or I think so. We have here red something floating, I guess, roses or parts from roses, I assume. And here we have Rhine. I guess this is roses. You don't see it really well now in the picture, but since they're roses, would make sense. And then I guess it's Rhine here, maybe. I don't know, or it could be also just grape juice. I don't know, but yeah, but should be a huge statue. I mean, look, the chair and stuff are small, so it should be a big statue. Furniture Dark Anchor Gateway. Oha, you get a big one, guys. Look at that, a big dark anchor for your home. Ooh, that's huge. I mean, look, with the tiles and everything, that looks like a really big thing. Impressive. Furniture 5 Companions Tome. That's nice. That's really nice. Oh, that looks really pretty. That's really cool. Cool idea. That's a really nice idea. Then we have Furniture Music Box Ascension to the Ruby Throne. That's also cool. You know, all this themed stuff is really nice, yeah? With this, and look, this is cute little music box with all of that. I hope it will look also nice in-game that you can see actually the characters. But it's a really cool idea. Furniture painting the stitches. With elsewhere painting, nice. Then furniture Reveille Sparkles. Yeah, all the sparkles and bling bling I enjoy always, but I find them often too expensive. Yeah, also I hope that this one doesn't look so big, this sparkle, so I hope it's reasonable. And that we can, you know, that it's not too expensive with either gems or Seeds of Endeavor to obtain them. Then we have a statuette, small statue, I assume in for ESO Plus. Auriel of Galas Agi? I don't know. Another statue from the Imperii, the Blight Lord Dragon. And then furniture, target Serpent's Image Trial. Oh, that's the target dummy, or? I guess it's a target dummy. Nice. So then we have hairstyle, Titanborn's Tresses. Okay. More hairstyles are always good. Then we have Head Sotasil Novelty Mask. Then we have next Fabulous Diamond Eyes. Then we have Head Markings Face Art of the Five Companions. as I think in general, all the ideas to bring, you know, costumes, hairstyles and everything related to the five companions is really cool. Especially for people who play a long time and have also connection to the base game and the tutorial and the main story. So that's really cool. I hope that also many new people who maybe never played the main story get inspired to, you know, try that out. But then we have Headmarking's Golden Eye Gaze. That could be nice. Oh, the eyes are also golden. I did not see that. I just thought it's the tattoo here, but the eyes are also golden. Do you see that? See? They are bling bling. Wow. I want to see that in-game. Because it does not look so much spectacular here on the picture, but maybe in-game it's more fancy. Rose of Tamriel's face marks. Sure. If you always wanted to have a flower on your head, there you go. There you go. Then we have head markings, soul burst, face soul markings. This one I could imagine. Here, this one for my Argonian character. Here. That one. That I see, could see that will work. For humans or my elf, not. Ajit. I don't know, maybe I have to test it, but Argonian, I can see that should work right. House, Mary Ryan Estate. Yeah, there are new houses on the PTS, which will... Oh, I don't know. As we will check them out on stream, but I don't know when. Because the anniversary event is not so long anymore and I don't have any of the style pages, so we have to farm that. And I want to watch the stuff on PTS. But we have to see. But we will watch the houses on PTS also. But it looks pretty, oh? On this picture, I would say it looks like it will be too big again for the furnishing slots what we have. But it looks really pretty. I mean, you have here the... I guess it's a vineyard here, or? You have here... Die Mühle. I try to get the English word, right? I don't know. How do you say that? Mühle. This one here. Oh, sorry. This one here in the corner. Where you make flour. I don't find the word now. Windmill. Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you. Oh my god. Sometimes I'm a bit slow. Thank you. Oops. Yeah. 1.3 million for this house after achieve. Oh, really? This is not a Crownstone exclusive house? Oh, that is great. That is great. Thank you, guys. I did not know that. It's good that they also bring back some, because mostly these big houses, or any houses, often are only, or not only, but often Crown Store exclusive. But I always find it good if they introduce new houses, which you can obtain with gold and stuff like that. It's really nice. That's really nice. Thank you. I didn't know that. Looks cool and pretty. And we get lots of space. As on the picture, I would say you get the windmill. Here you have some, I have no clue, storage, house, and lots of garden. Nice. That's pretty cool. Then we have house, Rose Vine Retreat. I guess it's the apartment what we can get with 3k. Or for free if you have a new character. Then we have house, Sun Kai Crest. Looks like it's in Elsewhere. Probably. I don't know, but it looks like that. Oh, it looks like that. Then, next we have house guest Fenorian. Oh, people will like him. Fenorian is usually quite popular character, so I assume he will be a character which people want to buy. This house, the house Sanjay K. Crest, will be Crown Store and later. Okay, thank you. Thank you for the help. So then we have house guest Imperial Legionary Larina. I don't remember her. As if we did visit her, meet her in some kind of quest, I don't remember her at the moment. Then we have Memento Anchorite's Carved Bone. Oha. It looks pretty impressive. Yeah. But if it's expensive, then I would probably not purchase it. Ooh! Mount Alavelis Ringed Gua. Oh, grass are always cute. Huh? Yeah, and he did fall into paint. A bit. Pretty cute. And we have a moose. Mount Sea Ghost Pillion Moose. For two people. A two-player mount. Something else. It's not a horse. That's quite nice. Then we have Mount Grudge Rock Belva. And another two-player mount. Nightmare Pillion Cursor. So we have already this fire horse. It's one of the old ones. And fire lion and stuff like that. And now it's for two-player there. Then we have the Mount Palefrost Elk. Don't we have that already? Or we have something similar? I don't know. Also, something like that we have already. Not sure if what sound different, but something like that we have. Then we have a new camel. Yeah, different colored camel. Piebald camel. Then we have, oh. Then we have a pyrotraconic camel lizard. Okay. This one, also, to be honest, I probably don't need it, but that was really funny. If it really spitting fire, that's pretty awesome. It's ridiculous and it's funny. I mean, at least it looks like it's spitting fire, so we have to check that out in game for sure. I mean, that's quite unique. It looks really, really unique. I have to check that out. It looks at least fun. So, do you need it? No, but it looks fun. Then we have the Sai Sahan's Reveille Olsin. Ay. That's lots of bling bling, huh? Lots of bling bling. Look at all the sparkles and metal and shiny stuff and I don't know, diamonds or whatever stones they are. Lots of bling bling. Then we have Mount Sand Squall Durzok. Next is Mount Shackled Titan. A big one. Then we have Mount Tarn's Lucent Reveille Sentry. Also lots of bling, colors, sparkles, everything. but it looks nice. Also, it looks nice. It depends now how it will look in-game. And as you know, I'm not a huge fan of so much armor. At least in the picture, it doesn't look bad. Then we have Mount Titanbones Reveille Wolf. As you know, I'm collecting wolfies in ESO. This one I am not feeling at all. Because he has like socks and shoes on. And helm and stuff. I will check it out in-game, but... I would not buy it. Also, I can't see myself buy that for 4,000 or something. That's expensive. And I have so many wolves already. Also, I will check it out in-game, but first impression on the picture would be like a skip. But I don't know. Then we have... a horse. Mount Varen's Reveille Cursor. This one... also. I mean, ESO always has the problems that the legs of the horses look broken, like really broken all the time. But here now with this socks, yeah. I mean, tastes are different. Okay, as if you like it, guys, it's totally fine. It's okay. But don't get mad if I now say something like I don't like it so much. But the horse itself is cool. The horse, but. All this stuff here at the bottom, I really don't think is necessary. That's just me. But the form on for the legs, or the shoes, I'm not sure. But if you want to have that, there you go. It looks interesting. It looks really unique. Yes, it does. And here we have warm cultist Senshirat. That's, also, that's not my thing. That looks really spooky. But it's pretty unique. I mean, I could imagine if you play with a necromancer, then you have their, I mean, it's really fitting. Look, all these hands, ghost hands coming out of this mount. That's pretty unique, at least. But not my mount. No, I don't see that using myself. One pause, look, it's wearing boots. That screenshot, yeah, it does not look like there's lots of form, but it's also really dark. So I'm not sure how well, because I think there could be nails, but I'm not sure. So it's pretty dark, so it's pretty tough to see how they look like, really. Yeah. Non-combat pet. Let's go with something cute. So a pet, a retriever. Aww. Good boy. Even so, I really like dogs, but often in ESO they look not so pretty. But it's still cute. It's a retriever. It's cute. Then we have it's a pet. Cold Harbor Ocular Observer. It's a pet, actually. Probably following you around. We have the all-seeing eye is with you guys. Then we have another book. Companion. Also, it's a pet. Companion Reveille Tombshell. Then we have a sheep. Cream and coffee sheep. Then we have a honeybee. I wanted to say it's a torch bug, but it's not. it's a torch bug with cosplaying a bee. I don't know. But yeah, it's a bee. It's cute. Why not? Why not? Then we have non-combat pet Meowny Marco. Oh, there you go. I think I said it right. Meowny Marco. Yeah, I said. Then we have a bug, Mistral Thunderbug. Okay. Also, why not? Why not? I never had the wish and the need that I said, oh yeah, I'm missing the Mistral Thunderbug as a pet, but maybe someone else. Why not? I don't care. Then we have another pet, the Strid River Crab. Or the Stride. Probably Stride River Crab. Then we have Torn Gecko pet. Then we have a little gra, the Trilob Bantam gra. Gras are always cute. Then we have the Winterhold Chestnut Pony pet. Outfit style, arms pack, eyelid, lich style. That's one you can purchase. Don't know for how many crowns. Then we have the arms pack, gold road dragon. Dragoon, I guess. Then next we have the arms pack, the blind. Would be nice, maybe. As always, I have to see that in-game. Bow. I'm always for the bow. The shields look always the most impressive, but the weapons could be also interesting. Depending how it looks in-game, but could be really nice. Then we have the outfit style, Companion Reveille. Pretty. Okay, it could be pretty depending how you can dye it. If this purple is all purple and I can't change it, then I don't like it. Like, do you remember we got once this costume? I don't remember how it's called, but I bought it and then we could not dye it. And then I was really sad. And then we did not use it. So, and I don't know if that's still the case too. I would be surprised, but yeah, who knows? Problem might be the green jewelry. Yeah, as I think the green, as I assume here, you're right. I assume here on the hood, this jewelry, on the chest, here on the trousers, the jewelry, And maybe here also that one and the shoes. They're not dyeable, I guess, so too, yeah. Iron one, one of the NPC, I think, yeah, yeah. Also I'm not sure how it's dying, but the costume, also the outfit style looks really nice. Also it looks cool, but depends how it's dyeable. Oh, ah so, okay, this is in the crown crates then. So if we now see here everything, now we see single pass, then it's in the crown crates. Because it's really, really nice. And we see here in the back, you have the companions. And it looks really pretty, as there's lots of detail on the outfit style itself. But that's really nice. There's lots of stones. Look at that. So I don't think they're dyeable. I mean, see, there's so many gems everywhere. On the shoulder, on the gloves, on the hip thingies and everything. So the chest, hands. So also I guess there will be... Yeah, and here also in the hood. But it's a nice style. It's really, really, really well done. And there are also weapons. There's a bow. And there seems to be lots of sparkles. Sparkles, sparkles. Sparkles, sparkles. Yeah, lots of bling bling. If you don't know the song from Seed, check out Bling Bling from Seed. I always have to think about it. More like Ball Illusion Polymorph. Ach, okay. If you always wanted to be more like Ball in small, there you go. Now you can have a polymorph, guys. Yeah. There you go. There's another polymorph, the Vampiric Soul Razor Knight. Then Skin Borales Wolf Pet. Pelt. Sorry, not pet. Pelt. Wolf Pelt. Skin of the Anchorite. Shot. Oh, the end. Ta-da! We made it. We made it. Yeah, about the skins, I'm not sure. How they will look like. I have to see that on my character. As always. But yeah, I hope you found something in the data mining what you liked. As said, you can check out the link in the description. Thanks again to ESO Model Viewer for preparing all the data. I really appreciate that. And yeah, I always enjoyed watching data mining. Even so, I said I don't know if and when the stuff will be released, but it's always nice to have a sneak peek about the upcoming items. I really liked it. I hope you enjoyed it too. Was there something what you want to get really, really, really very excited for?